Welcome to the Spark, digital learning knowledge.
2018 English Paper 1 of Aga Khan University Examination Board SSC Part 1 Examination. We will begin the paper with a 25-minute listening comprehension section. You will hear recording of two passages. Each passage will be played two times. On each passage, you will answer questions written on your Paper 1 booklet. Listen carefully to the first playing, then open Paper 1 booklet and read questions 1 to 6. You will get 2 minutes for reading. The passage will be played one more time. You can make notes on your question paper. When the passage has finished, enter your answers on the separate answer sheet provided to you. You will have 3.5 minutes to pencil in your answers. Follow the instructions on the front page of Paper 1 to show which of the options A, B, C, or D you have selected for each question. Do not turn over the page until you are told. Now, please listen to the passage.
Snow leopards. Good morning. I am a wildlife photographer, and just recently I have once again traveled the high roads of the snow leopards country. I saw no snow leopards, but sensed their presence. Feeling lucky and thrilled to be under the distant gaze of this magnificent cat. Today, I will introduce you to this magnificent creature. The elegant snow leopard is one of the world's most isolated and mysterious cats. Sparsely distributed across 12 countries in Central Asia, it is usually found in high, rugged mountain landscapes at elevations of 3,000 to 4,500 meters. Snow leopards, also known as the ghost cat, are solitary creatures. They usually hunt at dawn and dusk. They are successful hunters, able to kill prey up to 3 times their own weight. Their beautiful spotted coats change with the seasons, from a thick white fur to keep them warm in winters to a fine yellow-gray coat in the summer. The fur also helps them while hunting, as due to the color of their coat, they can easily remain hidden in their surroundings. The pattern of spots on the fur is unique to each individual snow leopard. Poaching, conflict with people, and loss of prey are persistent threats to this rare cat. Over the past 20 years, the population of snow leopards has declined by at least 20%, though exact numbers are uncertain because these cats are so elusive. Snow leopards' favorite prey is the mountain sheep or goats that share their habitat. These herbivores, that is, the mountain sheep and goats, graze on the sparse alpine plants of the region. Without the snow leopard, there would be too many herbivores, which would overgraze and degrade the natural habitat, leaving no food for other wildlife, and hence disrupting the balance of the ecosystem. The snow leopard's habitat also provides important resources for many people who live there, from food and medicine to wood for shelter, heat and fuel. So, by helping to protect the snow leopard, we are helping to conserve its environment for the benefit of people and nature. The conservation of snow leopards may also be commercially beneficial because it can attract many tourists.
Read questions 1 to 6. You have 2 minutes time for reading. Listen to the passage again. While listening, you may keep the question booklet open in front of you.
Snow leopards. Good morning. I'm a wildlife photographer, and just recently, I have once again traveled the high roads of the snow leopards' country. I saw no snow leopards, but sensed their presence. Feeling lucky and thrilled to be under the distant gaze of this magnificent cat. Today, I will introduce you to this magnificent creature. The elegant snow leopard is one of the world's most isolated and mysterious cats. Sparsely distributed across 12 countries in Central Asia, it is usually found in high, rugged mountain landscapes at elevations of 3,000 to 4,500 meters. Snow leopards, also known as the ghost cat, are solitary creatures. They usually hunt at dawn and dusk. They are successful hunters, able to kill prey up to three times their own weight. Their beautiful spotted coats change with the seasons, from a thick white fur to keep them warm in winters to a fine yellow-gray coat in the summer. The fur also helps them while hunting, as due to the color of their coat, they can easily remain hidden in their surroundings. The pattern of spots on the fur is unique to each individual snow leopard. Poaching, conflict with people, and loss of prey are persistent threats to this rare cat. Over the past 20 years, the population of snow leopards has declined by at least 20%. Though exact numbers are uncertain because these cats are so elusive. Snow leopards' favorite prey is the mountain sheep or goats that share their habitat. These herbivores, that is, the mountain sheep and goats, graze on the sparse alpine plants of the region. Without the snow leopard, there would be too many herbivores, which would overgraze and degrade the natural habitat, leaving no food for other wildlife, and hence disrupting the balance of the ecosystem. The snow leopard's habitat also provides important resources for many people who live there. From food and medicine to wood for shelter, heat and fuel. So, by helping to protect the snow leopard, we are helping to conserve its environment for the benefit of people and nature. The conservation of snow leopards may also be commercially beneficial because it can attract many tourists.
Now record the answers to the questions in the multiple choice answer sheet. You will have 3.5 minutes to record your answer. Now we will play another passage. This will also be played 2 times.
Secrets to revision that can improve your grades. How do you get the most out of revision time and end up with the best grades you can? Or, if you are a different sort of student, how can you get the same grades you are getting now but spend less time revising? Scientists think that analyzing the way people play computer games is a great way to study learning, because people spend many hours practicing computer games, and those games automatically record every action people take as they practice. Players even finish the game with a score that tells them how good they are. Here are a few suggestions to help you revise for exams. The first suggestion is to space your practice. Analysis showed that people who leave longer gaps between practice attempts go on to score higher. In fact, the longer the gaps, the higher the scores. The second suggestion is to practice the thing you will be tested on. The big mistake many students make is not practicing the thing they will be tested on. If your exam involves writing an essay, you need to practice essay writing. Merely memorizing the material is not enough. The third suggestion is to structure information. Trying to remember something has been shown to have almost no effect on whether you do remember it. The implication for revision is clear. Just looking at your notes won't help you learn them. Instead, you need to reorganize the information in some way. Whether by making notes of your notes, drawing a sequence to organize information, forming abbreviations, making flowcharts, and thinking about how what you are reading relates to other material, or practicing writing answers. This approach, called depth of processing, is the way to ensure material gets lodged in your memory. The fourth suggestion is to rest and sleep. New research shows that a brief rest after learning something can help you remember it a week later. This is great news for those of us who like to nap during the day, and is a signal to all of us that staying up all night to revise probably is not a good idea.
Now read questions 7 to 12. You will have 2 minutes time for reading. Do not turn over the page until you are told. Listen to the passage again. While listening, you may keep the questions booklet open in front of you.
Secrets to revision that can improve your grades. How do you get the most out of revision time and end up with the best grades you can? Or, if you are a different sort of student, how can you get the same grades you are getting now but spend less time revising? Scientists think that analyzing the way people play computer games is a great way to study learning. Because people spend many hours practicing computer games, and those games automatically record every action people take as they practice. Players even finish the game with a score that tells them how good they are. Here are a few suggestions to help you revise for exams. The first suggestion is to space your practice. Analysis showed that people who leave longer gaps between practice attempts go on to score higher. In fact, the longer the gaps, the higher the scores. The second suggestion is to practice the thing you will be tested on. The big mistake many students make is not practicing the thing they will be tested on. If your exam involves writing an essay, you need to practice essay writing. Merely memorizing the material is not enough. The third suggestion is to structure information. Trying to remember something has been shown to have almost no effect on whether you do remember it. The implication for revision is clear. Just looking at your notes won't help you learn them. Instead, you need to reorganize the information in some way. Whether by making notes of your notes, drawing a sequence to organize information, forming abbreviations, making flowcharts, and thinking about how what you are reading relates to other material, or practicing writing answers. This approach, called depth of processing, is the way to ensure material gets lodged in your memory. The fourth suggestion is to rest and sleep. New research shows that a brief rest after learning something can help you remember it a week later. This is great news for those of us who like to nap during the day, and is a signal to all of us that staying up all night to revise probably is not a good idea.
Now record the answers to the questions in the multiple choice answer sheet. You will have 3.5 minutes to record your answers. Thank you and good luck.